Let's quickly connect with Bina Engineer ET at Sanghi Industries. Welcome to the show, Bina. A very good morning.
Good morning.
We've just been hearing reports that cement prices in India, in Mumbai, have been cut by around 11 to 13% currently. Is this the right information that we're picking up right now?
Yes, for Mumbai and Maharashtra, there appears to be some drop in prices. However, so far as we are concerned, we have very small quantum of sale as an overall percentage for Mumbai. So it's not a major impact for us.
Yes, Bina. So you're saying that, yes, prices have gone down in Maharashtra. What's the impact that we could see in terms of margins? Will it have an impact because Jan to Feb prices have gone up by already 22%?
That's right. So generally speaking, the whole of the FY18, the prices have been better than the FY17. And this period last year was followed by the demonetization, etc. So we have generally better prices, except some marginal aberration, which are more seasonal, in my opinion, rather than a long-term impact on the prices. So there could be marginal impact on the EBITDA on account of Mumbai sales, but otherwise, I don't expect this to be a long-term trend.
Right. And overall, if you could just help us understand, what's the reason for the price cut?
As I said, for us, it's a pretty insignificant amount of sales here. So we are generally not leader in setting the prices, but we follow the market trend.
Apart from that, Bina, you know, we're just picking up flashes right now, which are saying when Nitin Gadkari has come out and said that there should be a reason for increasing cement prices, thinking of stem action against cement companies for cartelization. These are lines which we are just picking up right now from Nitin Gadkari. Anything that you have to say in terms of this? Because, you know, it's not an allegation, but the government is of the opinion that, yes, there is some bit of cartelization that's happening amongst cement companies.
So these are very regional incidents, or could be one-off incidents where there may be an allegation of cartelization. However, PCI has been very active and cement companies are very closely monitored over the last more than 10 years. So I don't see that this is a very common or prevalent concept. I have no idea what is the
I think
the diesel has gone up. The cost of transportation therefore has gone up. Which is these power, fuel, and the transport costs are the major cost factors for any cement company, and therefore I can see that there has been a cost, incremental cost over as compared to the last year.
So, Bina, are you trying to say that all the price increases that have happened in the recent past, as we just mentioned, 22% in the month of January, February, is mainly on the back of input cost pressure, and that is something that cement companies will be able to justify to the government as well in case, you know, any action is taken?
I cannot speak for all cement companies, but what I'm trying to convey is that there has been a cost increase, and ultimately cement is a very capital intensive business. Unless a certain return on investment is given out by the industry, industry cannot sustain. The turnover to fixed asset ratio in cement industry has been typically very low, around 1-1.5 times. And therefore, unless that kind of return is generated from the sales and on investment, industry as a whole cannot sustain. You might have seen that all the merger acquisitions have happened in the range of about $125 to $145 a ton capacity. That itself, and even the replacement cost is about $110, $120. So that itself indicates that the cost of investing in a cement plant has been very high. And therefore, one has to generate the corresponding return on equity or return on investment.
Right.
So that is what justifies that a certain level of margins will have to be maintained by the industry for long-term sustenance.
Right. So that's in terms of where award coming in on the back of cartelization. Bina, coming to you again in terms of where Sanghi is concerned, what's the capacity right now? We know you're looking at expansion in terms of by FY20, for you, which you've already raised 800 crores through debt, in debt through long-term loans, and around 400 crores through a QIP. What's the update on that?
Yes, you are right that we have achieved the financial closure for raising the capacity from 4 million to 8 million tons. And only this week we have also substituted some high-cost debt with a low-cost debt by substituting the non-convertible debentures at a lower cost of almost by 5%. So these are the two things which will help the company, and the project implementation is on the way, and it's expected to take about 2 years of implementation time. So we are looking at April 20 as expected commencement date.
Right. Bina, there is an expectation that once the capacity expansion takes place, at least by FY20, analysts are expecting Sanghi to post an EBITDA per ton of almost 1,085 per ton. Do you think this is a realistic number?
So if you see last 3 to 4 quarters, we've been clocking about 950 to 1,000 rupees per ton. So I believe that the same range has to continue. Minor ups and downs on account of prices, realization, costs are all bound to happen over the period of next 2 years. But on the whole, I don't see any major upheaval in that. So we expect that, yes, around 950,000 rupees is the base EBITDA which we are anyway generating. We have taken some cost-saving measures like implementation of receipt recovery, etc. And even this interest saving which I just mentioned would be, though it's below the EBITDA, but that would also add to cash surplus. So we do expect that things should only improve.
Right. Bina, again, I want to come back to the cement prices as well. I know we spoke about it in terms of the cuts that have been taken currently. But we just want to understand over here is that currently it is going to be peak season. It's going to be peak demand in terms of where cement is concerned. At a time when the demand is peak, what's the reason for the industry to take a price cut, at least in these regions?
Few factors have been playing off, like implementation of RERA, particularly Mumbai Municipal Corporation not giving permission for the additional new construction in the absence of new DP being announced. So this could be a more regional instance rather than a very larger across the pan-India instance.
So, Bina, you're saying that, yes, there has been a slowdown in terms of where real estate construction activity goes, and that's the reason why we've seen a cut of around 11 to 13%.
I'm saying this in reference to the Mumbai and the surrounding.
Correct. But do you think a similar trend will come in other regions as well, where we will see first price cuts happening? And number two, in the going quarters, will the trend in terms of cement prices inch lower?
I don't anticipate so, because as you know, generally the March to June is the best and dry season for construction. A lot of infrastructure work gets completed before monsoon. Same applies to all the IHB, individual house building segment, as well as for a larger construction project. So this is generally a good demand season where maximum sales has been clocked in this quarter. So I don't see that a drop in demand or drop in price is a general phenomena for all companies across all regions. I perceive that this is very specific to the Mumbai and the surrounding region.
Correct. Bina, taking your point that currently it is specific to the Mumbai market, but with RERA coming into place as a hindrance over here, one, will it even come to the other states where RERA is getting implemented? And number two, are you saying that we could rule out a price hike in the coming quarter?
I don't want to make a prediction on the price because this is very market-driven and demand-driven, of course. However, as I said, I do anticipate improved and stronger demand in coming months. Besides that, yes, on one hand, there has been a RERA impact on a larger metro or second metro areas. On the other hand, there has been a significant work that's happening on the low-cost housing on the second, third tier cities and the rural segment. So probably they are balancing out each other. And the infra demand has been quite positive.
All right, Bina, pleasure speaking to you and thank you for sharing all the details as well. So that's the management of Sanghi Industries, clearly indicating that it's mainly the input cost pressure that had led to this kind of a price increase. And number two, it's the Mumbai market which is seeing a price cut only because of RERA implementation. There are hiccups that real estate companies are facing. The demand is slightly slow in Mumbai, but not ready to predict as to what's going to be the next step. Whether in the season time when we usually see cement prices going up, do we rule out another cement price hike because a cut has come in this time around? So that's the story so far in terms of where cement prices are concerned. The stock as well, down almost 1%. But let's quickly slip into a short break and then we'll put the focus on telecom stocks and discuss the possible delay in the acquisition of Idea Vodafone Towers. Please stay tuned.